How can we use technology to prevent chronic diseases at a personal level? Today, we can customize our IT system such that it can fit the way we work, the way we play, or the way we live. At the same time, the world is faced with an epidemic of chronic diseases. Millions are dying from stroke, heart diseases, and diabetes. Even in a small country like Singapore, out of 3 young adults today, one of them will be a diabetic by the age of 70. Can technology be used to control this epidemic of chronic diseases? The answer is yes. The reason I say that the answer is yes is because the cause of this epidemic is not in our genes. If the cause was in our genes, then we are doomed. The cause of this epidemic is in our lifestyle. The environment that we are living in today is not conducive for healthy living. Food is in abundance, work is automated, and leisure is effortless. And this luxurious lifestyle that we have is killing us. It's killing us slowly, but it's killing us surely. It's not surprising, therefore, that we have an epidemic of obesity, not only in urban environment, but also in rural environment. Coupled with that is the tobacco smoking problem, as well as alcohol abuse. The traditional approach in controlling this chronic disease epidemic is by providing general health education. The belief is that if you are given the right knowledge, it will translate into right actions. Unfortunately, you and I know that having the right knowledge does not always translate to right action at the point of decision. Research has shown that making the right choice must be so simple and so much of a reflex action, just like a spinal level reflex. And the way to do this is to be able to prompt us and encourage us at the point of decision making to be able to choose the right option. Imagine in a day, not too distant future, where our wearables like Google Glass, as well as the Apple Watch, will not only be providing us with information, but it becomes a personal decision support system that continues to give us and advise us, as well as motivate us to take the right choice. We can do this by having the ability to predict risk at the individual level. There are several tools out there in the market, but unfortunately, these are based on group data and based on overseas studies. What we're doing back at the National University of Singapore is to take a big data approach. Through this approach, we develop what is called an agent-based simulation system, whereby the system will produce virtual copies of the Singapore population as it stands today. We can then virtually age this population and see the risk of development of chronic diseases. The starting point of this system is the massive amount of data that is out there, ranging from the census data, health data, surveys data, hospital data, as well as research studies, both local and international studies. All this data is passed through a complex statistical and bioinformatics machinery to discover the relationship between all these items of information. And this translates into the various virtual copies of virtual population of Singapore. We are in the process now to convert this agent-based simulation system into a virtual health concierge. When I subscribe to this virtual health concierge system, it identifies similar individuals within the virtual population that are like me, and basically take all these individuals and age them over time. Through it, it can provide personalized risk information and also be able to customize a prevention program and encourage me to continue in this prevention program and see how my risk can be further mitigated. This system that we have developed can go beyond health promotion. It can be extended from cradle to grave to the time where we need to have screening for diseases, and even to the point whereby we come down with disease, whereby personalized medicine can also be delivered through such a system. The question that I would like your input today is, how do we make such a system a consumer product that can in fact lead to a change in behavior? Thank you.